My name is Meg Glover, I am 10 years old, and I'm a stroke survivor. When I was a week and a half old, I became very ill. My mom took me to the doctor 7 times, and each time they told her I was fine. But my mom knew there was something seriously wrong with me. I wouldn't stop throwing up, and I lost a lot of weight. Finally, they put me in the hospital for observation, and there I started having seizures. After completing many tests, such as a spinal tap, which is a needle put into my spine to pull out fluids, and CAT scan of my brain, the doctors told my parents that I had a blood clot and a bleed on the right side of my brain. The doctors said that they couldn't fix it because if they gave me medicine for the clot, I could bleed more, or if they gave me medicine for the bleeding, I could clot more. I was rushed to McMaster Hospital in Hamilton on an ambulance where I was diagnosed with a blood disorder called C5 factor Lyme, and I had also suffered a stroke. All my family could do was pray for a miracle. After a few days, the clot began dissolving and the bleeding stopped. I began eating more and the seizures also stopped. After a couple of weeks, I was released from the hospital. The doctors were hopeful that I would grow and develop like normal kids, but they also said I might have physical disabilities and possible learning problems. Immediately, I began occupational therapy to help strengthen my left side by helping control the stroke. My left hand was always held tight to my body, but after months of therapy, it got completely better. Over the years, I developed normally. I even walked at 9 months old, proving all the doctors wrong. They thought I would be much later to walk. At the age of 2, my parents noticed that I couldn't wiggle my toes on my left foot. More damage from the stroke. At age 4, my left leg didn't develop or work as well as the right one. It is smaller and shorter. I was then diagnosed with slight cerebral palsy, another problem caused by my stroke. I now had to wear a special AFO brace to help my muscles in my leg. It was hard at first because I did get teased a bit. Some people even called it the bionic leg, but I didn't care. If I stopped wearing it, it would increase my chances of surgery even more. I also started physiotherapy again and had to miss a lot of school. Physiotherapy is really hard. Luckily, I don't have many disabilities. I began reading before I started junior kindergarten, and I work really hard to get good grades. Everything seemed to be going fine for me again until January 2008. I once again had another seizure. The first one since I was a baby. 2 summers ago, I had more seizures than the doctor had prescribed medicine to stop them. When I have a seizure, I don't remember it, but my family said they can be scary to watch, even though they don't hurt me. When I come out of the seizure, I have a very bad headache, and I feel sick to my stomach. I'm also very disoriented. I have been diagnosed with epilepsy, and now I have to take medicine called Tegretol twice a day to control the seizures. Sometimes seizures can be just staring into space. I can lose seconds of time and not remember what happened. I now have migraine headaches and have to watch what I eat. Once again, I have to do physiotherapy because the seizures made the muscles go tight in my leg. This will help prevent a surgery. Sometimes it hurts a lot. My family, especially my sister, never let me feel sorry for myself. We just stay positive to pull me through. Although I love school very much, I miss a lot of doctor's appointments. I have 3 doctors, 2 neurologists, 1 for epilepsy and 1 for stroke clinic at Sick Kids Hospital, a pediatrician, a physiotherapist, a hematologist for my blood disorder, and an orthopedic surgeon for cerebral palsy. Sometimes it feels like no one could possibly understand what I've been through, but it helps to talk about it. I'm very grateful for everything I have, and I accept me the way I am. I'm very thankful for my family, friends, my great teacher, especially Mrs. Morgan, my grade 4 teacher, who never let me give up, and kept pushing me to be the best I can be. She made it easier at school every day. Without the help of the Heart and Stroke Foundation, much needed equipment and research would not be possible without kids like me. My family has taught me to support charities like John Griffin, who's retired, and Sick Kids Foundation. No matter how hard it is you have it, there's always someone out there who has it harder and can use your help. It is always nice to give back and help others in need. I've never referred to my situation as a disability. It is an illness and one day we will find cures for the Heart and Stroke disease. I tell my story to educate and let people know that you can always help your dreams no matter how hard it may seem. Just recently, I won the Children's Hero Award from Kitchener, Waterloo, America for all of my work in the Heart and Stroke Foundation. discrimination awareness. Once on a school stage in the winter, I was singled out and yelled at by two instructors because I couldn't put my left foot a certain way or I couldn't keep my balance very well. It was only my first time skiing. I finally lost it and showed it. I have cerebral palsy, which I usually don't do. In the end, I learned how to ski my own way. Also, just recently, I got a new medical brace. I chose some pretty cool colors, which made me think it was fun to wear. Right from the first day, I got teased again. They referred to me as Terry Fox. Right away, I went straight to my principal because I thought I was being bullied. He gave me an explanation of ignorance and bullying. Ignorance is when someone doesn't understand something very clearly and comments are made that may be hurtful. If comments continue to be made, then when bullying occurs. It is now my mission to stop ignorance by telling everyone that I'm a stroke survivor with physical challenges. I'm hoping that if I can stop ignorance, I can stop bullying too. Nothing is impossible, I never give up. Even though I'm a stroke survivor, most of all, I'm still just me, and I wouldn't change a thing. Thanks, and always stay.